Alright guys, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a password-protected page in Showit. It's a little tricky because you actually have to create a blog template and then add that page to WordPress, but I'm going to walk you through all of the steps. So, to begin, we need a page. So, I'm going to duplicate our content page to WordPress. And we're gonna name this pricing because most likely if you're password protecting something on your Showit site, it's probably your pricing. And I'm gonna get rid of all of the stuff that I do not need and just come down to a very basic template. And then from here, I'm going to add a paragraph, and we don't actually have to put anything in this paragraph. But this will just tell Showit and WordPress what size content area to allow on the page. I'm gonna make that smaller. And then I'm gonna change the settings on this text box to make sure that it is post content. So there we go, post content. And I'm gonna make this canvas height grow with content. And I'm gonna do the same thing on mobile. Make this bigger. Post content, center it, click off of it, make this grow with content, and then I'm going to just adjust the size of this so it's not super big. And then from here, I need to get to the actual page settings, so we'll click onto pricing, and we're going to change this to be a custom template, and then we're going to do page, and then whatever name you name your page. So if this was like page pricing, it would be, for me, it's page pricing. If this was like an album design page and you were going to name it album, you do page-album. So it's page-whatever the name of your template is going to be. So we're all set up, so I'm going to hit publish. And then I'm going to come over to my WordPress account and I'm going to create a new page. And I'm going to call it pricing because you want to make sure that all of the names match. And I'm going to make sure that the URL is dash pricing because this URL, the slug, needs to match this page slug right here. Otherwise, they're not going to connect. And then from there, we can change the visibility to password protect it. We'll make the password Krista just to make it super easy. And then if I wanted to add like a PDF in here for people to download, or if I wanted to type all my pricing information in, I could do that. Or I could do download the guide and then copy it and add my file. So we'll upload that media file and I'm going to copy the link. And then I'm gonna select this text and I'm gonna hit the link. I'm gonna add that and then I'm going to hit publish. And then if we open up a new incognito window where I'm not logged in, so you can see it's kristajones.com/pricing, we can put in our password, and this page would actually need a few styles to get it to look right because you can't see the password box, but we could put in Krista and hit enter. And then we see the text that I put in, and then we can download the guide. It goes right to my guide. And the cool thing about this is that you could go back to Showit and like you could add styles in Showit like above the area where you download things and below, like this is all done in Showit. So there's a lot of room to be flexible with this and still password protect a page. The only thing you can't do is password protect the entire page. You can only password protect a specific like WordPress section. So hopefully that helps.